Hello, this is Colin Goble. The purpose of this demonstration is to show you how to write a C++ program to open and read a file of data stored on your hard disk. In this case, I have a folder called Demos stored in my CS161 folder. And in there, I have a file of numbers. It's just a file that I created with Notepad. If I open it up, you'll see this file happens to contain 6 numbers. There happen to be 3 numbers per line, and each is separated from the next by so-called white space. Notice I don't have any commas there or any other punctuation. White space is a space character, as you see between 1.0 and 2.0, or a new line character, as you see between 3.5 and 4.5. So there are 6 numbers here, and my purpose is to show you how to write a program to open that file. Remember, the file is called numbers.txt, and it's in, by the way, it's in exactly the same folder as the program that I'm going to write, called file-read.cpp. Okay, let's open up dev C++. Here's the program that reads that file of numbers, and our objective here is to add those numbers up to calculate the total, and we also want to find the average of those 6 numbers, so we need to count how many numbers there were and divide the total by the count to provide the average. We're going to, as usual, need to do I/O. We're going to need to format the I/O. And one thing that's different in this example is if we're going to open files on the disk, we're going to need to include the Fstream library from the C++ standard libraries. Fstream is the library that handles streaming, input-output streaming to files, to the file system. So we're going to include Fstream, and we're going to deal with strings, so we're going to include strings. Okay, in our example, all of the numbers are, we're assuming the numbers have fractional parts, so we're going to calculate the total. It's going to be of type double precision floating point. The count of the number of numbers that we're going to process, that's an int, of course, it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so we're going to declare that as an int. And later on, we're going to need a reply of type string, number of type double, and there we are. Now, our output, I'm going to use 2 places of decimals, so we're going to use fixed point output as opposed to scientific. We're going to show the decimal point even if the number turns out to be a whole number, so we will want 3.0 to display as 3.00 and not as 3. So this sets the parameters for our output stream: fixed point output, show the decimal point, 2 places of decimals. Now, the first thing that we need to do here is prompt the user to tell us where the input file is. So we're going to write a prompt. We're going to output the prompt input file name followed by a colon. There's no ENDL there. We'll leave the cursor on the same line. And I'm going to read the input that the user supplies in response to that prompt. So I'm going to get the whole line up to the enter key that the user enters. I'm going to read from standard input, CN, and I'm going to read what the user types into a string variable called input file name. So I'm assuming the user is going to enter the path to where their data is stored on disk. The next thing we need to do is open that file for reading in this particular case. Now, input file, which is declared here, is an object of type ifstream. So this line here is just a declaration of a variable. It's just like int count, except the variable name is called input file, and instead of being of type int, as you can see, it's of type ifstream. It's an input file stream. We're going to open this file for input. So the syntax here to open this is input file, which is this variable here, our input file stream, dot open, and then we have to provide in the parentheses right here the name or the path to the input file that we want to open. Now, essentially, it's the string that we just read in from the user. It's this thing here called that we just read in, input file name. But we have to manipulate it a little bit before we can pass it to the open command right here. The problem here is that the file open command was designed many years ago, and in C++ there are two kinds of strings. There are the original and old way of handling the string data type, which goes back to the early original days of the C programming language in the 1970s. And then there's the much more modern string data type, and the string data type was not introduced into C++ until much, much later in the 1998 standard, in fact. And the problem is, the open command, because it's been around for a long time, requires old-style C strings. So we can't just pass it input file name. We have to write there dot C underbar str left paren right paren. It's pretty nasty syntax. But the objective of that syntax is to convert the input file name from the new modern string data type to the old style C way of handling strings, which is what the open command needs. So I'm sorry about that. It's a little bit ugly, but I'm afraid it's necessary in this program to get the file open. Okay, now when we try and open the file, of course, there are a number of there's two possibilities. If the user's provided a valid file name, then the file will open successfully. But it's also entirely possible that the user made a typing error, and so the file doesn't, in fact, exist on the hard disk. So the next thing we need to do after we try and open it is ask the question, input file dot is open. That expression there returns true if the input file opens successfully, and of course returns false if the input file failed to open. So the exclamation point here is the NOT operator, the Boolean NOT operator. Not true is false, and of course not false is true. So if it's not true that the input file is open, then the file didn't open successfully. We'll output a couple of error messages here. We'll tell the user we were unable to open the input file. We'll pause right there to stop the message flashing off the screen, and then we'll exit the program with an error code of 1. So if the program reaches this point right here, we know that the file did open successfully and the program didn't exit. If we get here, then the input file opened okay. So now we need to enter a loop. We need to go round and round and round, reading each number from the file in turn and counting how many numbers we've read and what the total is. It's really important, if we're going to count something, that the variable we use for the counting we set to 0 initially. So we've set count equal to 0. Count was declared as being of type int here, but unlike some programming languages, C++ doesn't automatically set it to 0. So if we need to set our counter to 0 initially explicitly, and this assignment statement here does that. Similarly, if we're going to accumulate a total of the numbers that we've processed, we need to set the accumulator to total, which we do right here. That's really exactly the same thing as when you're adding a set of numbers on your calculator. The first thing you need to do is clear the whatever's in the display on your calculator, clear out what's in there and set it to 0 before you begin adding your new set of numbers in. So we need to, in calculator terms, clear out the calculator. In programming terms, we need to initialize the count and then the total to 0. And then all we have to do is read the contents of the file token by token. This loop here, the while loop, we read one token from the input file and we read it in to our variable called number. Now number here is declared as being of type double. It's a floating point number. We're going to read from the input file one token into number. Remember that this greater than sign means take the next token from the input file and store it in the variable called number. Now very conveniently, having read the next token from the input file into number, we're going to increment the count by 1 because we've just read one more number. I'm going to output the number right here, so we're going to set a column width of 5. We're going to output the count, so the count is output write justified in the first 5 print positions of the output. We're then going to set the next field to have a width of 20, and we're going to output the number that we just read write justified in the next 20 columns. So when we look at the output in a moment, we'll see that the count is in the first 5 columns and the number that we've read is in the next 20 columns. And having done that, we will add the number into the total. Total plus equals number is a C++ shorthand for writing total equals total plus number. We'll add the number into the accumulator, if you will, the thing we're calling total in this program. And we're just going to do this in a loop. Right here's our loop. We're going to do this for all of the numbers in the file. And of course the issue with loops is at some point the loop has to terminate. We can't go on doing this forever. And quite naturally, in this case, we want the loop to terminate when we reach end of file. So we want to keep reading numbers from the file until we get to the end of the file. The solution to that in C++ is very convenient. The greater than operator reads the next token from input file if there is one. If there is, the value of this thing is true, so the while loop continues to execute. However, very conveniently, if you try and read from the input file into that variable called number, and the read isn't possible because you've reached the end of file, then the greater than operator returns a value of false, which causes this loop. Instead of continuing, it causes the loop to terminate. When the loop terminates, the flow of control goes on to the very next statement here. At that point, we output the value of total. And now all we have to do is divide total by count and output the value of the average. The average, of course, is the value of total divided by count. There's one little gotcha you need to think about. It might be possible to open a file that has no numbers in it at all. In that case, the count is equal to 0. And if we were to divide 0 by 0, you'd get a runtime error in C++ because dividing by 0 is not a valid thing to do mathematically. So the average only exists, in fact, if the count is greater than 0, hence that if statement. So, having printed the total, having printed the average, we need to close the input file. That's very simple. We do that here. And as always, these last two statements are to stop the output flashing on the screen. Okay, so having explained that, let's try it. Remember, here's the file that we're looking at. It's got a few tokens, each one separated from the next by white space. Each token is a valid floating point number. And if we run the program, let's compile and run. It compiled okay. The input file name. Now, the input file name was called numbers.txt. I'm going to input that. Count is 1, the first number is 1, the second token is 2, the third token is 3.5, etc. There are 6 tokens in this case, the last one being 9.54. The total is 28.30 and the average is 4.72. So there's the output from the program and everything has completed satisfactorily. Now, this only works because the file numbers.txt happens to be in the same folder as the executable program. In this case, that file happens to be in the same folder as my demo program. Alternatively, I could have put in a full path name, and I'll just demonstrate that. I could have typed in C:. In my case, it's in a file folder called CS161, and then it was in a folder called demo, I think, and the file name is numbers.txt. This version of a file name is called a fully qualified path name, and it works all the time. You specify the entire path to the file from the root of, in this case, of the C drive, and we get exactly the same output. Well, that concludes my demonstration of this program. I hope you find it helpful in understanding how to process data from an input file. Thank you.